Hi everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So I have a sample of indium here, which has some teeth marks in it because this is the same sample of indium that I bit a couple years ago in my biting indium video.
Just like that.
Now in that video I mentioned that indium was incredibly soft, and it is. Indium is one of the softest metals, and I also mentioned that indium was about the same hardness as sodium. Well, I've been working with sodium a lot lately, and I have to say that's not exactly accurate. Sodium is so soft that you can actually squeeze it and smash it in your fingers. Indium, on the other hand, you really can't do that with it. See, I'm squeezing as hard as I can and it's barely deforming. So I'd say indium's quite a bit harder than metallic sodium. Now I know the first thing that you guys are gonna comment on is, why don't you take a bite out of the sodium? Because it's softer than indium, you should be able to bite through it. And this is true. Biting into sodium, though, sounds like a very terrible idea because it reacts vigorously with water, and your body's mostly made out of water. But from working with sodium as much as I have, I think I might be able to get away with it so long as I'm very quick and I mostly touch my teeth, because my teeth don't really contain much water. I am going to recommend you guys don't try this at home. Usually I don't say that because it's sort of hypocritical because here I am doing it at home, but this is one thing that's rather dangerous. There's a small possibility of having a Coulomb explosion going on in my mouth, and that sounds like a very bad idea. But here we go. Let's try it out. So, kind of dry my teeth off here. Let's take a bite out of this. There you go. A little bit tangy. I think the splatters onto my face from putting it into the water so close to me was a little bit worse than actually biting it, but there we have it. Some sodium with some teeth marks in it. That was unpleasant, but obviously I survived. A little bit tangy. I don't think it caused any damage, really. Really turned the very tip of my tongue into soap, but I'll recover. So there you go, biting sodium. In fact, Kangin, you want to come get a close-up shot of me doing that for the thumbnail? I think I'll actually bite it, but I won't bite all the way through. I'll just kind of put my teeth on it. Oh, got sodium bits on my nose here. Come on. Wait for me to get this out. There we go. Okay, ready?
Yeah.
So, here's a piece of sodium. It is covered in oil, so that's probably helping me. Tastes hot and very mineral oily. There you go. Now, I know a lot of you guys are probably going to want me to try tasting potassium, because sodium basically just tastes like regular old table salt, really, except a little more tangy. Potassium tastes like bananas. At least the potassium salts do. I haven't actually ever tried the potassium metal. Now, potassium is a bit more reactive than sodium, so much so that it will instantly ignite on contact with water. So I'm not really going to try biting through. I'm not even going to try biting this at all, actually. The risk of a Coulomb explosion is much higher. Let's cut a little piece of this off so you guys can see how hard this is. Potassium is much softer than even sodium is. In fact, it's about similar to what sodium is to indium. See, I can just pull it apart with my fingers here. It's a very soft metal. In fact, potassium is so soft you can actually squeeze it through a syringe if you push really hard. But, like I was saying, it instantly ignites on contact with water. So, here we go. Kangin's gonna do a high speed of this. See? I'd rather it not do that in my mouth, so I'm not going to try biting potassium. So, there you go. Hope you all enjoyed. I'll see you next time.